sun setting on the highway as we leave NASCO and barrel down this across our country to the great state of Minnesota. I'm going to talk to you about trade school seminar I went to. So this is really cool. I really enjoyed this one. And it was really well put together, really well facilitated. And just, you learned a lot in a short amount of time because it was hands-on, but not in a way that was, like, phony. It was really applicable, and it wasn't, like, sometimes it's like, hands-on for the sake of being hands-on, but it was really applicable. So a trade school, you know, you think of a trade school as, you know, a plumber's school or a carpenter school, a practical skills higher education, right? But that's kind of a play on words because they have their emphasis on practical skills. And so this is their symbol, their logo, right here. It's a bell with a fork for culinary arts and a knitting needle underneath. So it's kind of funny. It's a school that started in New York, but now the model is being implemented all over, and it's even moved to Milan. And so the whole system is completely transparent. They don't have a cooperative administration yet, but they're moving towards that. Right now it's more hierarchical, but they give out this pamphlet of like how the entire thing is organized and how many people you need to hire on, what kind of space you'll need, what kind of jobs you'll need done in order to start your own trade school. And I'll post this so you guys don't have to try to read this from here. But it was really cool, and then the whole business of it's all transparent, so that more trade schools can start. So what a trade school is it's a barter-based education, right? So you're exchanging ideas for goods. It's the whole basis. So how it started is from this thing called ourgoods.org, and it's kind of like a Craigslist, but the whole point of it is to connect people's haves and needs. So somebody's like, ah, man, I have all this lacquer and I need some wood. Or someone's like, I got this wood, you know, I'll trade it for you because I really need a piano or, you know, whatever. It's anything. So that was how the site worked. But they wanted the site to be more person-to-person, and it was working like a Craigslist thing. Someone would go and drop stuff off, someone would go pick it up. But they wanted it to be, like, encouraging human interaction that you can't get over the computer. So they did this thing where they all met up in a gallery, a bunch of Our Goods people, and did a swap and met and everything, and everyone just enjoyed it. It was a huge success. There was tons of excitement. So they used a Kickstart to start up this trade school in this gallery. So one of the bases of their website, organization, is their website. It pulled in 180,000 views last year, and they say that's why it's been so successful. So they have this really beautiful, really well done professional website. And all you need to do for a teacher is you propose a class, sign up to teach it, and then list your needs. And your needs are what you expect in return for teaching the class. So that includes like materials or any resources or tangible, like attitude or effort. So that's really beautiful. Labor, how they work out, professional website. And all you need to do for a teacher is you propose a class, sign up to teach it, and then list your needs. And your needs are what you expect in return for teaching the class. So that includes like materials or human resources or things intangible like attitude or effort or time or like labor helping your house or things that are tangible.
What about money?
Tangible, but never money, because it's a barter system. Or connections, whatever. As long as it's not money, you know, you trade it. So then they review the classes, and you're pretty much guaranteed to get in, first come, first served, as long as your class isn't something that... I was giving an example of a class that did not fit their values. So they had a man come in and do a class and retire before you're 30. So a bunch of people signed up, you know, people are pumped about that, and they show up, and the class is just about how to oppress other people in order to make money off of them. So they were really offended by that. So So there are some classes, very rarely, that get rejected that they don't put up. There's another one called, like, teaching children how to express their love for themselves, put on by a man, so that freaked them out too.
How old do you have to be to go to this trade school?
It's any age. So it's any age, and the whole point is any age, any economic background. The majority of people are people who are out of college, out of grad school, in the working world. It seemed like it was about 30 to 50 people that were attending, but it could be anybody. And it was a lot of people who, you know, couldn't get an education otherwise, or weren't able to get education when they were young, or people just don't have the money or the resources or the time to take classes, whatever that means.
Is this kind of like EXO in the Minneapolis? The EXO school, except there's bartering?
It's similar. I don't really know how EXO works. I haven't looked into it very much, as much as I'd like, but I know that's a preschool as well. But the bartering thing is really appealing to me. It's really something that I think people have to apply if they can teach it. So that means that some people have to have a class.
Is this kind of like EXO in the Minneapolis? The EXO school, except there's bartering?
It's similar. I don't really know how EXO works. Sign up for a class and it's just free, there's no investment. You know, you go for a few classes and you skip a class, you know, because you have a prior engagement, and then the next week you're like, well, I skipped the one last week, so it won't be too bad. You know, and you keep skipping. But if there's some kind of investment, financial or otherwise, people are more likely to attend it. So that's why I like the barter system better than I like the free system, especially for like our co-op or something.
What are the qualifications for the teachers of this like trade school? Can it be anyone? What? Do they have to go through training?
It's a great question. Yeah, it's absolutely anyone. They encourage anyone with any skill set from any teaching ability. They actually prefer to have both trained teachers. Okay, so I want to talk about how they define bartering. So they define bartering as a social exchange. So it puts the teachers and students on the same level. They're working together because they're both getting equal things out of it, saying, I'm giving you just as much as you're giving me. And this equals the investment. It equates to a relationship, and that brings it to an emotional connection. So that even deepens your investment even more. So it's not like you go to Starbucks, you give them a dollar, they give you a cup of coffee. Bam, it's over. It's an investment that involves time and emotions and sharing and things that connect you on a more personal level. So that's why it's a social exchange instead of social like transaction. Transaction is quick, you know. It's the exercise they had us go through, which was really nice. It was great to see how this model can work. They had us, everyone write down five or six things that they have. So that's why the social exchange instead of social transactions. So I wrote things like studio time for recording or something. Like said they had us go through, which was really nice. It was great to see how this model can work. They had us, everyone write down like five or six things that they have, that they need. So that's how we started with our needs. And so I wrote things like studio time for recording, or someone to fix my bike pedal because I keep not getting to it, or a place to stay while I'm traveling, or teach me how to use a synth, or like seeds from someone's garden, stuff like that.
Microcord.
So, how to use a microcord, yeah. I didn't say microcord because I didn't think people would know what that meant. and so then there's this huge list that came out of everyone listing their things, and all of a sudden, bam, we have this beautiful things. You're looking at it, you're like, wow, I want to learn how to do that, I want to learn how to do that, I want to learn how to do that. So you see like, all these, I'm backwards. So this huge list of things, and people list things that you're able to provide. You're like, wow, I can totally give them that, I can totally give them that. And then it's break up in pairs with somebody who we can provide one of their needs they listed. So I got with a girl and she was interested in music lessons, guitar lessons. And so she was like, oh my gosh, I told her, we actually exchanged emails, and I'm going to send her a video. I have this 15-minute guitar lesson spiel that I like to give people. So I'm going to send her that, and then in return, she's going to send me a recipe, because it was one of mine on my list, was teach me a cool recipe, a recipe for pumpkin pizza. So that's really cool. So we saw that, and that was powerful enough. And then we broke up again and individually wrote down things that we thought we could teach. And this is where it got really cool. So I did things like writing and editing articulately, human physiology, guitar, note-taking, composting, vermicomposting, natural medicine and introduction, how to be in a band, because I've been in bands my life. So this huge list blew up, and this list was 3 times the size of our needs, and it was the things that people could give. And you look up at there, and it's like, wow, I really want to learn how to do that. There's a guy who's going to teach viola lessons, right? So there's all these like awesome things that you totally want to participate in. And I turn to the girl next to me, I'm like, I would love to go to our school like right now. So that was really cool to see, like, wow, this is really powerful, and we all have so much to offer. So it's really cool to reflect on yourself. So as far as the administration goes, this is the woman's email. ALUTKIN@gmail.com. Again, ALUTKIN, alutkin@gmail.com. I would show you the paper, but I wrote it really illegibly. And it's called The Trade School in New York. I have all its information on it.